During the 1930s, the building of the Boulder Dam, now known as the Hoover Dam, attracted a huge influx of young mill workers to help with its construction. With this came many families that made Boulder City their home, and with that came family pets. The makeshift pet cemetery was built illegally on federal land about 5 miles outside of the city, and it has been named one of the most haunted pet cemeteries in the nation due to its hauntings of both pets and human spirits that make this place their home. One legend tells of a phantom cat that will follow its curious visitors, keeping a close eye on them and their every move, occasionally brushing against someone's leg as if it's trying to catch their attention. A second legend tells of the spirit of a local teenager that was killed in a car accident just a few yards away from the pet graves. He is said to manifest himself as a curious shadow that will appear and disappear behind bushes while you explore the area. The third, and probably one of the creepiest, tells of people who became victims of mafia hitmen and were drove out into the cemetery only to be murdered and have their lifeless bodies buried in a makeshift grave using the pet cemetery as part of a murderous ingenuity.
Oh my God!
Tonight, we decided to come out and see if these legends are true, so sit back, turn off your lights, and join Katie and myself as we venture into one of America's most haunted pet cemeteries and try to make contact with its ghostly residents.
Oh my goodness.
This thing just told us to leave now.
So the story behind Ernie is we were communicating with some spirit of a boy who happened to pass away somewhere along the highway right here, which is the 95, with the day after his graduation. Was it that we were able to research? Like, he was maybe 18, I think it said. It was a teenager. But anyway, we were communicating with him and it led us right here to the spot where we had placed Ernie. And I'm sure you guys already know who Ernie is. So it had actually asked us to leave him here, so which we did, and it's been what, maybe 7 months he's been here.
Can you separate the rods if you want me to leave Ernie with you to keep you company?
So we left him and hopefully maybe we can get communication with him again tonight. Maybe.
Try to see if we can communicate with the teenager that we're communicating here last time. The reason we say it was a teenager was because last time we were here, we found some information about one of the teenagers dying, like Katie said, somewhere along the highway. We're not that far from the highway. We're probably about, what would you say, about
quarter mile
from the highway. That's why you guys might hear cars. The audio might be picking up the cars and all that. But this is Ernie right here.
Not as colorful.
This one be low. He's all dusty now, but he wasn't that way before. He lost a lot of color, didn't he?
Mm-hmm.
I think the sun burned him. All right, guys. So Katie turned on the ghost box. Hopefully you guys can hear it. It is a bit windy, so we're gonna do our best with the audio. But we're gonna try to see if we can communicate with whatever might be here.
When it starts beeping like that really loud, and then you'll see it go up into the red, then, you know, sometimes the voice will come through. It sounds a little scary, but it sounds like demonic.
Does it?
It does, it's pretty freaky, especially if you're by yourself. but I've actually been able to get some pretty good responses back to me.
All right.
Considering, you know, what I was asking.
All right, so let's find out if he's still here. If the spirit of the person that we talked to before is still here, can you talk to us through this device? That beeping means what? That something's
it's
trying to come
closer
through?
It's getting closer, and yeah.
What the hell was that?
I told you, mistress.
What? Alright, so word mistress came through the box. I don't know if you guys can see it. Let me see if I can lower my light here a little. It says mistress.
It's gonna come back through.
Alright. Can you give us your name? So when it's beeping like that, it's trying to come through or something?
Yeah.
Is that what it's doing?
Yeah.
Alright, I've never used this device, guys, so this is Katie.
I actually, the best place I got information from was out in Duck Creek. It's the first time I ever used it, and it was like spot on with my question.
Alright. So it sounds like it's trying to come through again then?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Sam. Told you, dude.
Oh my god, that is crazy. All right, guys, so there you have it. Like, we just started, but we just asked for
the name.
And like, you guys saw it a few seconds later, the name Sam came through. So we're gonna assume this is a person we were communicating with last time. If you guys recall the story that I told you before this video began, allegedly the mafia was using this pet cemetery as a burial ground. So I'm not surprised if several names come through. As a matter of fact, the name Paige just came through the device. I'll show you.
And it's like, coming back.
It seems to be coming back again. The name Paige just came through the device.
And I can even bring up a log too of the things it said.
All right, so let's see. That beeping sound indicates that something else might be coming through. See if it's another person here.
Sometimes it won't say anything and it'll just go away. But if you hear it like that,
it says
creepy,
steal.
Like steal.
The word steal came through. Let me see if I can adjust this light.
I can turn my brightness down too.
I turn down a little bit. You see if I can capture it with a.
My phone wants to work.
Oh yeah, that's much better.
Let's see, it's getting red again.
Totally red, so that means something might want to come through.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Oh damn! I've never seen it do that before.
What did it do?
The whole thing shook.
Your phone?
Yeah, the whole thing shook. Nothing came through. What in the heck?
Wow.
I've never seen it do this. Like, not to this extent.
So that means something might be here?
Mm-hmm.
If you're here with us, can you communicate with us through this device and say yes or no?
I would pull up the EMF, but my phone will...
I'll grab it.
Oh my god.
This thing's going crazy.
I'm gonna screen record this real quick.
Yeah, you should. That thing's going wild. All right. So I got the EMF detector in one hand and the ghost box on the other hand.
Oh. Last?
Last. Wonder what that means. Do you want us to go to the last plot in the cemetery? Is that what you're doing? Can you say yes or no, or make this device light up?
Make this device go to red, that way we know. Wow, I've never seen it do that before. Yeah, the whole entire screen shook.
Is that it?
Like you could see it vibrate, like all this stuff.
I don't know if I got it on camera. Hopefully
it even shook my phone.
Did it?
Mm-hmm. You
never done that before?
No. Never seen it do that before ever.
Hmm. Wait.
I've never had two words come in at one time.
No, what happened? What did it say?
Baby crying. What the?
Focus.
Come on. Let me turn my brightness down. I think I turned it up. Yeah, I turned it up.
Perfect. Turn this.
Baby crying. Never had two words like that.
But why do you think it would say baby crying at a pet cemetery?
I don't know. Going crazy.
I wonder if there's a baby here. I hope not.
Can you see that?
Yeah. Is there a baby here? How do you call it a baby? Is baby the name of your
Took?
Pet? Oh, it says Took.
You took a baby, or somebody took your baby?
Dude, remember that girl's name, Paige? Holy, I'm getting chills too right now.
Holy shnikes.
You're getting goosebumps. You can see it through the camera.
Oh,
you're
my gosh.
You're getting major goosebumps here. Oh, man, this is crazy. What else is trying to come through?
I don't know.
Paige, did someone take your baby? There's a light shining. Oh, it's way over there. Whoa, what did that say?
That was cool. Larry?
Larry. Dude, this is...
I'm getting...
This is crazy. We're getting actual names and detailed accounts.
Somebody
here, guys.
Larry took...
Oh, I don't know
baby?
If you can see that, but I don't really get...
You don't get chills very often. Oh, my gosh. Dude, it's like almost 90 degrees and I'm cold.
It is. It is about 90 degrees and it is cold here.
You know what? Let me see. I'm cold. 82.
Guys, let me show you the temperature on Katie's phone, okay? It says 82 degrees and she feels like she's freezing, especially after those those names came through and it said baby crying. I wonder why it would say baby crying. Who's Larry? Larry, if you're here, make some kind of noise. Something's trying to come through again. Paige, was that your baby that Larry took? Can you say yes? Or was Larry the name of your baby? I wonder if we caught a baby crying in the audio. If whoever's watching the video, guys, keep a close ear out for a baby cry in the audio. Hopefully we caught something on camera. Sounds like something wants to come through, but it can't. Is something holding you back from coming through our box?
Ugh. Get off me.
They're all these bushes around there are like human size, and your mind starts playing tricks on you and you see shadows everywhere. I mean, maybe there is something here following us, but the only reason why I really haven't pointed it out is because it could be a bush, and I don't want to lie to you and tell you that I saw something when I probably didn't. So I'm gonna leave it up to you to tell me whether you saw something move behind us, or you heard or saw something. All right, so now the word force came through. Did someone take your baby by force? Dude, there's that light again. I just saw it. The light
Are
that you
freaking kidding
no,
me?
The light that you said you saw?
Yeah.
You know the light that you said we were following earlier?
Mm-hmm.
It just popped up again in the same area that we were headed to, but there was nothing there.
Are you kidding
No, I swear it blinked. Like really bright, and then it went away. There's no roads back there. In case you guys are wondering, there's absolutely no roads up in that area.
No.
There's nothing. Just desert.
Well, I'm not chasing it again, unless that's where it's saying, hey, hello. But we walked over there and there was nothing.
We walked through there and it didn't communicate with us though. So I don't know.
If that's where you want us to go, you need to speak to us. Sorry to be so mean about it. Something seriously keeps touching my legs.
Like, you don't know what it is?
No, it's not my shoelace, because I'll just be standing here. There's no way my shoelace is just going to fly up and hit me in the leg.
It touched you over when we were over by Ernie and the other statue, right? The other statue.
The other statue, that's where the first one was. It felt like something just right here on my skin. And then again, walking over to where we are now.
All right. Well, there is that legend of that cat that supposedly follows people around.
Right, but so, this doesn't feel like...
What does it feel like? Like a kid, a cat, a human?
I don't know what it could be. It's not a cat because I know the... Because cats will just brush
on you, yeah.
It's just like a touch. You know what I mean? It's
like
just,
a paw? Or
no, it's
a hand?
A paw.
A hand type?
Maybe. I don't want to say yes because I don't know for sure. But it feels like something... It feels too big to be, oh, fudge.
Remember the word crawl. The word crawl came through, so I wonder if something's crawling up to us and touching you. Because I haven't felt nothing, really, other than on the other side. Wait.
Yeah, that's part.
I haven't felt anything, really, other than on the other side as we were walking this way. I got major chills. Like for a while we're in that side, like major chills, but then it went away. I haven't felt anything. Like if something is here, I really haven't seen anything, heard anything, or felt anything. You keep feeling
something touching,
something touching your leg.
And then, while we're over there, still closer to Ernie, I see a gosh darn light, and that was gone.
Yeah, that's how we ended up over here, guys. We saw a light up in this area. Not that one. That's like way out there. The light we're talking about was closer, and it we can't find it. It just kind of disappeared.
It looked like
we don't know where it is.
Solar lights that just stick in the ground.
Yeah.
But now
people do leave solar lights for their pets here, and that's what we were talking about earlier. Because
bam.
Are you sure that's the one? That's too far.
That is too far.
The one that you said you saw was a lot closer, and we were almost there from what you were telling me.
Yeah, it should have been about right here.
But there's nothing here. You know, earlier today, I didn't catch it on film, but remember I told you I saw that light just kind of shooting down?
The green one?
A bright green light. And then later on, we saw another bright green light shooting off of that direction. Look, there it goes again. Look.
That's an airplane.
No, it's going to dissipate. An airplane wouldn't have been that bright, and then it dissipates, see? I don't know if any of you guys believe in UFOs, but we are in Nevada.
Hold on.
What?
What's funny is I was, of course, taking some Snapchat filtered, like, selfies. You know me and my Snapchat. But, here, just to back up that little thingy. Look at what's on there. That's the frame for Snapchat.
All right, hold on. Let me. That is crazy. That's guys, we are in Boulder City, Nevada. Okay, this is Boulder City, and look at what's up there. A little UFO. Now, I'm not saying there's a UFO here, but what I am telling you is this. We are in Nevada, outside of Vegas, and Boulder City is known for a lot of UFO activity. A lot of people see UFO craft flying above this area. Mm-hmm. Now, if you know, Nevada is a vast desert. There's a lot of landscape here, a lot of desert where UFOs or test crafts or whatever you might want to call them can fly back and forth without being disturbed. There's not houses here for miles. Even the lights that you see behind me over there, way over there, they're at least a good, I would say a good 5 miles from here, 5-7 miles. And if you face that way, where the highway is going, you will go on for at least 90 miles before you see a house. So, something else coming through?
Yeah, it just started beeping.
But the point that I was trying to make here is that I wouldn't be surprised if we see a light flying back and forth like Katie and I already saw. Unfortunately, we were not recording at the time, as it always seems to happen. But Katie was witness to one of them, and I saw a second one when we were trying to fly our drone. So I don't know, maybe there is something here. But again, to get back to the pet cemetery, let's check that out, see if we can find anything. By the way, if you guys want to see Katie and I go searching for UFOs, let us know
awesome.
In the comment. Wouldn't that be cool?
Yeah.
I don't want to get abducted though. So I don't
sure
want to.
You already haven't been abducted?
I've been probed before. I guess I can be trained. I'm already trained. All right, we're recording again.
Darkness.
No, dude, that is freaky. That is getting freaky. It's getting scary now. It's getting a little scary now. All right, guys, so my battery was dying as this was going crazy, and it's still going crazy again right now. Check it out. It just said choose, and then after that it said blood, and that's when my battery died. It just drained out of nowhere, and now the other word that came through said darkness. So I don't know if it's draining my battery to keep it dark here or what. What are you trying to show us in the dark?
Oh my God, it's topping out.
This thing is going wild.
Come on.
What are you trying to show us?
It vibrated again.
January.
Is that when you passed away?
We're getting a lot of hits through the ghost box, so we're trying to see if we can communicate with everybody. What does it say?
Already.
Already? That's funny, because I just said, I'm ready to leave, and the word already came through on the ghost box. That's wild, you know, when you're getting these communications and these things seem to answer the questions to specific questions. That's pretty wild, you know, because some of these things seem to answer specific questions to what you're asking. How do you explain that? I mean, could it be just that our self-conscious makes that come through, or could there actually be something to this whole spirit world thing? As a lot of you guys know, I am more of a skeptic than a believer, and I think that's why I come out here to try to prove and explore these legends that people talk about hauntings, because I want to try to disprove them or prove that something is here. The more I come out, the harder it is for me to remain a skeptic. With all the evidence that keeps coming up and all the stuff that you guys point out while we're out exploring, it's just, you can't help but to say that you're almost a believer, you know? We're here completely alone. We keep seeing flashes of light come up to the different areas in this desert. And, you know, we're getting different words come through the box. So we came here looking for ghost pets. And I think we ended up actually communicating with human spirits. So, I don't know what there is to this, you know? Could the pets, maybe after they pass away, be able to communicate with us through the ghost box and regular words?
If anybody knows, sure.
I mean, yeah, if you guys have any theories, please let us know what you think. Yeah, this thing's going crazy again. It's just...
I've never had this many hits, though. Especially with the multiple words at once. You went away. Cement.
Mm-hmm. You know, the monsters used to bury people in cement shoes. What they call cement shoes. You know, they used to tie them up.
Yeah, but don't they put them in water? Yeah. For the cement shoes?
Yeah, but could it be
Lake
that...
Lake Mead.
Maybe they had a plot here to fill them up with cement.
Good point.
No. I don't know.
Good point.
Oh, did you hear that?
No.
Tell me you heard that, dude.
I didn't hear it.
You didn't hear that.
What are you talking about? I didn't hear nothing.
It sounded like a baby.
Are you serious?
I'm dead serious. It sounded like a freaking baby.
I didn't hear it.
Unless it's a coyote yelp.
Coyote yelps.
But it sounded almost like a baby.
Playing your music. Shuffled.
I didn't ask for that.
It just by itself? Whoa. If there's anybody or anything here with us, if you want to communicate with us, come closer to us.
Shut off.
Dude, I swear I heard what sounded like a baby cry almost.
Coyotes don't sound like that.
I mean, they yelp, right? But yeah. From far away, could it be that from far away, it would almost sound like a
possibly
cry of a baby?
Possibly. Or a dying rabbit.
A dying rabbit, yeah. The rabbits squeal like...
They sound like
loud,
crying
right?
Babies.
Yeah. Cool. I mean, we are in the desert. There are snakes all around us. I want to know if you are still here and if you can tell me my name or Katie's name. Can you make one of our names come through the box or tell us what we have in our possession? If you do that, I will believe that you're around here for real.
See, every time you...
Every time I ask you, it sounds like it wants to answer. Let's start walking a little bit and see if we wait for it to come.
I kind of want to do both the rods at the same time, you know what I mean?
All right, we can.
About time.
What? What?
Oh my god!
Dude,
please tell me you were recording for my question. that I want to use the rods. And then immediately it says about time.
Katie asked if we should use the rods. And this thing immediately replied, about time. I got all that on tape.
Oh, you did?
I got it all on tape. I was recording the entire time. Yes, I was
recording.
Something else might come through. So we're going to pull out the rods here.
No way.
That is crazy. That is crazy.
Okay, let's bring them both out. We'll shut this off and then we'll bring the rods out and I can...
All right, so... It's like I was telling you, how do you remain a skeptic after you get these kind of answers, guys? Like, Katie asked if we should use the rods. Immediately, the ghost bog replied, what did it say?
About time.
About time. Like, something else is coming through now.
Lisa.
Oh, my God.
Ah! Dude,
no. No way.
Oh
no
my
way.
God.
No way. Guys.
Oh, I'm shaking. God.
We asked it earlier if they would say one of our names that would come through a ghost box. The last time we were here, my wife was the one that was receiving more emotional distress out of this place.
Oh.
Her name is Lisa. Lisa came through on the ghost box. Her name is Lisa. What the hell? And it's asking us to use the rods.
Okay, we'll bring out the rods.
I'm gonna pull out the rods
now.
No way!
I've got the chills like so bad right now.
Okay. All right. So, do you remember the last time we were here at the pet cemetery? You kept getting like more emotional distress out of all of us.
Oh, you're breaking up. I got on getting wet. More what?
All right. You remember last time we were here at the pet cemetery, right?
Yeah.
And you more than anybody else here was getting like more responses and a bit of more of emotional distress over being here, remember?
Yeah.
All right, so we asked the ghost box to say a name, one of our names, and your name's the one that popped up.
That's crazy.
Yeah, your name came up. And it's giving us a lot of names like baby crying.
Uh-huh.
Right, it said crying baby or baby crying. And it's giving us like blood and relics and stuff like that, like religious items.
Huh.
Yeah, really crazy. Remember the statue that's all the way in the back?
Uh-huh.
You told us that was used for something. I forgot what it was.
Oh, yeah. It's a saint or something. St. Gabriel or something, I think. I had to Google it.
Yeah. What kind of saint was he? Do you happen to remember?
I don't.
All right. We'll check it out. Anyway, I just wanted to tell you that because we both got super excited when that came through.
That's cool.
All right. Love you.
Love you too.
Bye.
Bye, him.
That is freaking crazy.
Leave now! Oh my God! Oh my God!
Wait, whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa. Wait. It's not focusing. There it is.
What the heck?
Dude.
Oh my goodness.
This thing just told us to leave now. How do you respond to that?
I don't know. Are you kidding me? Hold on a second. Because you were on the phone and I was holding the camera.
Yeah.
Lisa, and then leave now. Oh.
Decided. What did it decide? If there is anybody here with us that has been communicating with us, can you please cross my rods? Can you separate my rods if you need some kind of help? Can you point both rods in the direction where you're standing right now?
In the middle of us?
Maybe in the middle. Can you point the rods behind me and walk behind me? No, it's behind you.
Possibly.
If you're behind me, cross the rods, please.
The word blood came through. If that's a bad sign, separate the rods immediately. If someone hurt you and made you bleed, can you please cross the rods? I hope you guys are seeing that I'm trying to keep my hands as steady as possible and I'm not moving this. So let's see if we got any response. No new responses came through. If you're buried amongst people's pets, please cross the rods. If there are multiple spirits here, can you please separate the rods?
Something came through.
Evan. The word Evan came through.
Okay, now see if that
person... Let's see if we can communicate with Evan.
Bugs.
The word Evan came through in our ghost box. Evan, if it's you that's communicating with us now, can you please cross the rods? I want to know if you're a human or if you're a pet. Can you separate the rods if you're a human? Or you were a human at one point? If you're communicating with me through the ghost box, send me another word of something that I'm holding in my backpack, in my pockets, or that Katie has in her possession. Other than that, please point the rods in the direction where you're standing. Yo, that's where the bush is. Remember I told you I kept seeing someone peek in and out of the bush?
I want to see if I can get something.
Evan, if you're behind the bush...
Something came through again.
It says create.
Hmm.
Create. Evan, what do you want us to create? If you're behind the bush, peek your head out so people can see you on camera. You're welcome to peek out your head behind me if you have to. Would you come out on camera with us? If it's bothering you that we're here trying to communicate with you and the other spirits, please cross the rods.
As always, thank you for watching this video, and please remember to follow me on Twitter and on Instagram for exclusive photos and videos. Links will be posted in the description below.